regarding our reopening, which is happening this Sunday for our English service, Sunday, November the 8th at 10 a.m. So mark that down on your calendar. It's going to be an hour earlier than what we're accustomed to. It's going to be at 10 a.m., not 11, 10 a.m. once again. And that will allow us to prepare for the service that will follow after that in Spanish. And I know that last week we gave some protocols regarding the so that we can return to church and have in-person services. And I want to go over these protocols one more time and actually go into a few more guidelines that we're going to be putting into effect. And number one, again, we're going to be asking that everybody wear masks at all times. Once you get out of your vehicle, come into the sanctuary, we're going to ask that you have a mask on. Leave the sanctuary until you get back into your vehicle. We're asking, please, that you wear a mask at all times. Even, well, the only ones that won't be wearing masks are those that are ministering on the platform. But once they come down off of the platform, they will have a mask on as well. Number two, we're going to be practicing social distancing. You will be allowed to only sit with those that live in your home. You're not going to be able to sit with maybe your cousin that is part of PFAC but doesn't live in your home, in your own home. You're not going to be able to sit with that person. Only those that live in your house you're going to be able to sit with. Also, there are going to be no handshaking, no hugging, no physical contact of any kind. And again, I know this is going to be something difficult, but please help us with this. Remember, you know, once somebody extends their hand to shake your hand or hug you, remember, we're social distancing, and you can, everyone's going to have to please help us with this, okay? So no handshaking, hugging, or physical contact of any kind. Also, number three, we must use hand sanitizer anytime you enter the church or re-enter the church sanctuary. And we're going to have some sanitation stations set up in different portions of the church. Number four, if you do not feel well or are suffering with any sickness of any kind, we're going to ask you to please join us online. Also, those that you might have a family member that's home ill, we're going to ask you to consider attending our online services instead, okay? Number five, those who are 65 and older, as well as those who suffer with any pre-existing conditions or any chronic illnesses, will not be permitted to attend church services at this time. And again, we're doing all of this for the safety of those that will be in attendance and for those that are suffering with pre-existing conditions. Please stay home. Continue to watch the services online. This is a temporary thing that we're doing at this time. Number six. This is a new guideline that we put in place here. Parents with really small children are encouraged to join us online. But if your children are school-aged, can wear a mask, and can sit for the entirety of the service, then they're welcome to join you for an in-person service. But remember this, there's going to be no nursery, there's going to be no cry room at this time, or even children's ministry will not be provided during this phase of reopening the church. And also, we want to limit the congregating in the lobby or outside the entrance of the church. So when you get here, put your mask on, come into the church sanctuary, don't hang out in the lobby or outside the entrance. Come in, get your seat. And then when we leave, same thing. So we're going to be asking, please, don't congregate. Just help us with this. Head over to your vehicle, and then you can go home. Number seven, there's going to be no altar call, no gathering at the altar. Everyone will be encouraged to pray and worship in their seats with their family. And we've mentioned that we're going to have to get used to, at least for a time, you know, a different type of service. Something that we're not necessarily accustomed with, okay? So we're going to just be praying in our seats. The word of God will be released, And God will bless, God will heal, God will set free. But we're not going to be doing it at the altar at this time, okay? So just we're going to be doing that in our seats together with your family. Number 8, regarding tithing, there will be deposit boxes in the lobby on the sound booth wall where you can deposit your tithe and your offering at your convenience. But we encourage our members to continue utilizing Secure Give app for all financial contributions. It's a very simple and easy way to give. My wife and I have been using Secure Give for many years already. It's simple, it's easy, it's secure, and it's a very, very good way to give. So consider giving and continue utilizing Secure Give app. Number 9, the restrooms will be restricted to 2 people at a time. The ushers are going to help us monitor their use and their cleanliness. Number 10, the sanctuary will be properly sanitized after each service. So this is why we're going to need your cooperation. To immediately exit the sanctuary after the service is over, return to your vehicle. This is going to allow us to prepare for the following service because we're going to have to sanitize, clean the whole church after every single service. So please help us with this. Number 11, we will continue with our midweek Bible studies online. We're not going to have in-person Wednesday night service. It's going to be online. It'll continue on our Facebook page and on our YouTube channel. In the next couple weeks, we're going to share our 4-phase approach to the reopening of ministry activities, cell groups, and home Bible studies. So this first phase, we're just reopening the church for in-person services on Sunday at 10 a.m. We're not yet having ministry activities. We're not yet having cell groups or in-home Bible studies. That will come later in a different phase, okay? And we're going to be releasing that information in the next few weeks. These guidelines will be strictly enforced for the safety and the well-being of all those who will be attending our services. And we are asking all those who plan to join us for in-person services to please follow the directions and the instructions given to them by the ushers. Our ushers are going to help us enforce these protocols with the delegated authority of our pastor. So please respect our ushers. The instructions that they're going to be giving you, the direction that they're going to be giving you, it's going to be all delegated. It's coming from the pastor down to the ushers. So the instructions that they give, it's as if the pastor himself is saying it. So again, this coming Sunday, November the 8th at 10 a.m., our church capacity is going to be at 220 people. And one last thing, we are monitoring, we're going to continue to monitor the numbers of COVID cases in our county, as this will impact our ability to continue to have in-person services. So let's pray. I believe that God is going to move in a tremendous way once we open. His word is going to do its work. People are going to continue to be touched and healed, transformed, and saved. But please pray for our pastor, our church leadership, and all those, of course, that will be attending. And I know that God is going to bless us greatly.